YouTube, what is up? What is up, wrestling fans of YouTube? It's RS Mario here, and it is that time again. It is WWE pay-per-view time. This one, a little bit bittersweet for me, is WWE Fastlane. It replaces Elimination Chamber, which was one of my top pay-per-views of the year. So I'm a little bummed out about that. No Elimination Chamber, at least not yet. More than likely, it'll pop up at another pay-per-view sometime later this year. Probably SummerSlam or Survivor Series. Hopefully not that long. I don't want to wait that long for Elimination Chamber match. But at least this helps, because usually somebody gets injured, you know, during the Elimination Chamber and doesn't get to go to Mania. I think last year it was Bad News Barrett, who actually got injured at Elimination Chamber and did not make it to WrestleMania. So, I guess this helps this year for injuries. But this year, this card we have is it's a little light. Like, we've got 5 matches and we've got an interview with Sting. So, which I really don't understand, by the way. But let's hop into it. Nikki Bella versus Paige with Brie Bella for the Divas title. I'm going to tell you straight off the bat, I have no interest in the Bellas at all. Like, even though technically Nikki has improved, you know, she has improved her wrestling skills and she did pretty good in the last few months, I have no interest in the Bellas at all, other than the obvious. But, you know, I mean, Paige is awesome. Paige is one of my favorite divas. You know, she has the personality, she has the mic skills, even though her British accent makes her hard to understand sometimes. She does have the mic skills, and she has the wrestling skills to be an awesome diva. She won't win this match, though. More than likely, they'll save the big win for WrestleMania, you know, for her to win her third Divas title as a face, you know, have a big feel-good moment. She finally beat the evil, you know, the evil twins, and that was it. So, Nikki goes over, probably loses at WrestleMania. Next, we have the Usos versus Tyson Kidd and Cesaro. What looks like is going to be an entertaining match, because all these guys are awesome in the ring. You know, the Usos, even though I'm a little sick of them being champion, they're kind of becoming like John Cena. They're like the John Cena of the tag team division. But they are awesome in the ring. You know, like the tag team turmoil match on SmackDown was incredible. So, I have to say, hats off. Usos are awesome in the ring. Kidd and Cesaro has really gelled as a tag team, so you know, they work pretty good together, and they're pretty good in the ring by themselves anyway, so this is going to definitely be an awesome match. But I don't see Tyson Kidd and Cesaro picking up the titles here. The Usos are just holding those titles for the Ascension. When the Ascension is ready, they will take up the titles from the Usos. It's late. So Usos retain. Next, Bad News Barrett versus Dean Ambrose. Okay, now we get to the hard to call matches. These last 3 matches here are pretty hard to call, because both it can really go either way. I've heard a lot of people saying that Dean Ambrose could definitely walk out with the IC title, but I personally don't see why, because there's no other heels, you know, for him to go against. Now, they need a big match for him at WrestleMania, you know, so that's why I'm saying this match could definitely end with, I'm saying, Bad News Barrett. Bad News Barrett retains. I mean, the match itself is going to be pretty awesome. I mean, you got 2 brawlers. You got freaking Bad News Barrett, who's a legitimate pugilist. You know, he's pretty much a boxer. You know, and then you've got freaking Dean Ambrose, who's a psychopath street fighter. This is going to be a fight. It's going to be freaking good. And, you know, I see Bad News Barrett retaining. Either, you know, by nefarious means. He can cheat, definitely. You know, seeing as that he's been avoiding, you know, Dean Ambrose pretty much the entire time, he could definitely find a way to, you know, to cheat, you know, to hold a title, to kind of like build some heat going into WrestleMania, to have a big title win for Ambrose. You know, he finally defeats, you know, Bad News Barrett, wins the title at WrestleMania. So I see Barrett going over Dean Ambrose with shenanigans, possibly a DQ. Next, here I have another match that is freaking hard to call and is guaranteed not to end well. Well, I wouldn't say not to end well, but not to end clean. And that is Rusev versus John Cena. This match is literally the irresistible force versus the unstoppable force versus the immovable object. John Cena is, he's John Cena. I mean, he's won everything. He never loses, and when he does lose, it's never clean. That's John Cena. The only person I know of that has beaten John Cena somewhat clean, and that is Sheamus. And there's still been some controversy with it, but it's still there. And Rusev is Rusev. Rusev has destroyed everything they put in front of him. Even though, with every match, with every feud, he's been getting more and more human. When he first started out, he was destroying people just like it was nothing. And with every feud he got humanized a little bit and a little bit more. So it's very possible he could lose to Cena, but to me, it would be pretty irresponsible for WWE to build up a monster just to feed him to Cena, who we all know can beat monsters anyway. We need a young person to defeat Rusev, somebody like a Dean Ambrose, somebody who really needs a big win like that. So I don't really see any of them losing. Like, Cena can't afford a loss going into Mania to fight whoever. So I call this one. This one's going to be a DQ. No one's going to win this. And then we have the match. This is the match of the night. The main event. The match that has the most riding on it. The match that has the most opportunity for shenanigans. Roman Reigns versus Daniel Bryan. Okay, this match right here it feels like last year. You know, it does feel like last year, except, you know, they didn't have a match to determine who's gonna get the shot. You know, they just did it last year. This time, you know, the only real way they can get out of this is making a triple threat again. You know, because either they can turn Roman Reigns heel, which still kind of won't work, because who are you going to cheer for at WrestleMania? You really think they're going to cheer for Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania after what he did at the last WrestleMania? No. So, of course, you know, that's what are they going to do? I mean, because if Roman Reigns beats Daniel Bryan clean, that's it. He can't be a face anymore. It's going to be like Cena. He's going to get more boos than faces, or even cheers. The only people going to cheer him are probably little kids, some of them, and chicks who dig him. That's about it. Most people going to be like, no, screw that, because they want to see Daniel Bryan. So he can't beat Daniel Bryan. If he does beat him clean, he's going to turn heel. The only way I can really see this happening is if somebody else is the one who causes Daniel Bryan to lose, and all the heat will go to that person. And I do have an idea who that probably is. So they've been playing vignettes about him coming back for the last few weeks. And that person is Sheamus. And there have been rumors going around that Sheamus and Bryan are supposed to fight at WrestleMania. You know, and it will be interesting to see them finally get the match that they probably should have gotten, what, 3-4 WrestleManias ago? Sheamus could be the guy who causes Daniel Bryan to lose. And that will put a whole lot of heat on a newly turned heel, Sheamus. And the other freaking enigma in this whole thing, where the hell is Randy Orton? I mean, was he legitimately injured? Like, he's been gone for months. You know, I understand he did the movie, but the movie's probably done now. I don't know. So he could very well be a factor in this match as well. You know, I mean, if they really wanted to, they could have Orton come in and screw this match up. You know, they could have chaos happen. Brock Lesnar comes in there and they make it a fatal four-way match. Orton, Daniel Bryan, Roman Reigns, and Lesnar. I don't really see that happening, but it's possible at this point. it's better than any other possibility that they have. But the Sting thing. I keep forgetting the Sting thing. Yeah, so Sting and Triple H are gonna meet up at this pay-per-view. Face to face, painted face, Sting and Triple H. I'm intrigued. I have zero excitement for it. Cause I don't really understand the hype behind Sting. Sting is about as old, if not older, than The Undertaker. Sting has not been in WWE. Sting has been gone for like a decade plus. If you don't count the TNA stuff, which they aren't going to count. You know, he's been in TNA. He did pretty good work in TNA, even though some people carried him in TNA. But I don't really understand why Sting is such a valuable commodity. I mean, the only value I would see in Sting is to get him out of TNA. You know, I mean, but guess what? I mean, he was in TNA all that time and it did nothing. They're actually worse for wear right now. So, I mean, I don't really understand the hype behind it, but yeah. So, more than likely it's going to end in a staring contest, a promo, and a short brawl leading into a match at WrestleMania. So that's about it. Alright, so I've got several videos. Oh, I gotta do the matches. So just to round off the card, we have Nikki goes over Paige. The Usos go over Kid and Cesaro. We have Bad News Barrett going over Dean Ambrose. We have Rusev and Cena going to a DQ, possibly somebody ruining the match. And we have Reigns and Bryan going to whatever the hell they can do in that match. Because I really can't call it. I mean, because they make... I mean, the best way they can do it is to have Daniel Bryan win. The worst way they can do it is to have Roman Reigns win clean. You know, the only middle ground is to have somebody like Sheamus take out Bryan and have, you know, Roman Reigns win the match that way. So, I got a lot of videos coming. I got a Zelda video coming. I have the last Fire Emblem for Fire Emblem Week coming. Also, I want to do a pre-pay-per-view WrestleMania prediction. So, I've been looking at rumors and stuff. And I want to make a prediction card before the actual card comes out. So, another prediction video is coming. So, that's about it. Like, comment, subscribe, and keep it real.